A new film, my friends, about the nature of capitalism and so-called free market. Yeah, the market is free, but the people acting in the market are slaves and owner of slaves. They are not slaves like, you know, in the slave age, where people went to Africa and they bought slaves and they brought those slaves to America or to Europe. In fact, slavery existed till the year 1864, and it was last abolished in Brazil, if I'm correct. So, in the year 1864, we may consider that the slave age or the ancient age was over, and the medieval age or the, you know, the power age began. And so we only need to add 438 years to the year 1864, and just in a minute, 1864 plus 438, in the year 2302, all this Mayan calendar will be over. Only two more centuries to wait, three more centuries to wait. So, let us talk about capitalism. You know, I deeply admired Apple, and I tried to create a company called Banana Computers. I will try, because Steve Jobs is talking into my head, and I have read many books, and I have concluded after reading those books that the nature of reality is very simple. You must have resources, and by resources I'm not meaning only the iron, coal and gold which are inside the earth, or, you know, the resources of human work, let's say the corn which is planted, because you know the rain falls, and you see water is also resources. We must have water on this planet. If we don't have water, we can't have even bacteria. So we must have water. Water is a primary source, much more important than oil, for instance. I am watching Uruguay and Colombia is 1-0. You know, Colombia has the colors yellow, which is stretched to the superior half of the flag, blue and red. And with these colors, I can presume that they are the same colors like in the flag of Romania, only the flag of Romania is red, yellow, blue, and then they are vertical colors, not horizontal colors, but it does not mean, it only means that, you know, when we first went into space, our flying saucers first went into space in 1910, after the work of Henry Quandt. We have decided to flip our flag because, you know, when you launch a rocket, first you see, you know, the red of the, I don't know, fields, and then the yellow of the sky, or the yellow of the sun, and then the blue of the space which lies after the atmosphere. In fact, it is black space, but you know, it becomes blue and then black. So, red, yellow, blue, black. And also, there are also colors of the Jet tribes. I'm not going to get into much details. But you know, with this flag, Colombians show that they are an Aztec civilization, maybe a Mayan civilization, maybe Maya began in Colombia. Maybe it began in Uruguay, because the Uruguayan flag has the sun, and the sun is the sign of Apollo, which means that they are members of Atlantis. And they also have blue and white stripes, which also mean white is the color of the white race, of course blue is the color of Agartha. So we have Atlantis and the Gondar flag. It's very simple to interpret a flag or a symbol. Most countries have dragons. If you have a dragon with two heads or more, it will mean that there are two powers, like the Medians and the Persians, you know. Only in Russia, the Vikings and the Dutchians, you know. Or the Jete, the Massa Jete, and the Vikings. If you have only one head, and the head is, and the the head is looking to the left, it means that the vultures of the eagle or the dragon is looking at the glorious past. So it is an ancient civilization. If in the case of newer civilizations or countries like USA, Germany, Russia, England, the eagle usually looks to the right, which means that he looks at the promising future. And so the left is the spirit, right is the matter. Left is the man, right is the woman. We have if the eagle is flying, it has its wings open, or the dragon is flying, that means that that country or power is a great power and it is acting in the world, like USA or Germany or Russia or England or Spain. If the eagle stands with his wings closed or her wings closed, it means that that great power has passed over its time of, you know, conquering the world. If you see the history of Dutch FC, how we have conquered India and Japan and parts of China and parts of Africa and South America and parts of North America and so on. And now we are resting, you see. So nations and civilizations are like people. Some are old, some are young, some are middle age. France is a middle age, you see. Italy and Germany. Germany is new. So let me. Oh, but we are not talking about football, we are talking about capitalism. So capitalism is incredibly wasteful society. It is based on lust, on greed. It makes other people want things. It is written in the Tenth Commandment. It is not written you should not steal. It is said you should not lust after the woman of your neighbor or the cattle of your neighbor or after other beings belonging to your neighbor. Well, capitalism is based essentially on lust or greed, on envy. It makes people hate each other. So this is why we have dysfunctional societies in the West. We have the church, which exists, it is based in the ancient society, and it exists in order to, you know, calm people down. I have seen a documentary called Religulos from Ridiculous from Bill Maher, and he asked himself, he's a Jew, he asked himself, what is all this religionless? And he found, you know, a black pastor. And he had gold around his neck, and why do you wear so much gold? Said, well, you know, Jesus also received gold when he was a child, you know. But how many houses and palaces Jesus had? None. He was homeless. How much money and gold Jesus had? None. He was poor. Let's see. What does Jesus said? The man who has two breads should give one bread to the man who has no bread. So don't question about your life. Live your life fully today. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow shall worry about itself. Worry about today. Live like birds. Do not care if you are beautiful or ugly, for God has made also the flowers in the field which are burning fire. Transition to women, perhaps. So beautiful, and then he will make you also beautiful. Do not despair, trust yourselves, trust God. Yeah, these are the teachings of Christ. Once said Christ was a communist. And you know, Michael Moore said, wow, I like in my childhood when the taxes for the poor were 90%. Well, the taxes for the rich were 90%, and I was a poor child. Well, what does it mean to be rich? Does it mean to have $1 billion, $1 million, or $1,000? Because you know, a billionaire is 1,000 times richer than a millionaire. A millionaire is 1,000 times richer than the guy who has $1,000, and the guy who has $1,000 is 1,000 times richer than a homeless guy on the street. You see, and the homeless guy on the street is 1,000 times richer than a guy who is already dead. He's an undead vampire. You know, and I find curious about undead vampires, you know, like Bill Maher or others, that they do not believe in God. Because you see, they see that their immortal spirit inhabits their dead body. When they look in the mirror, they see their dead body. And they switch, like Dracula, to the doctrine of death. They say, oh, nothing exists except death. I am dead. But yet you are alive, you see. And they cannot pass judgment upon themselves and the world. And they begin to think that God does not exist. Why? Because they believe that they do not exist. The death of God is their own death, and they believe themselves to be dead. Now, but not all the people who are dead in the cemetery go around the world making movies, you see. So, we have this question, and I have studied Apple and the history of Apple, and I reached the conclusion that Apple was a little bit less wasteful, and they had some visionaries like Wozniak and Steve Jobs, people who worked, you know, because in the nature of today, someone must work. In order for you to have internet, there must be a guy or a girl who lays down a cable. You know, they mount a post and they lay down a cable from post to post and to your own block with flats. And they drill some holes and they lay down the cable, and then you will have internet. If there is no one to do this and to maintain the network, you will not have internet. So, if you believe that $30 billion to develop an operating system is too much, you are welcome to make a company and make it for less. If you believe that 40 years of work is too much for an operating system, you are welcome to make a company or not and make your own operating system for less. If you believe that the big companies are charging you too much, you are free to make a neighborhood company and charge less. As people in Romania did in the 1990s and 2000. Because there were no regulation. The best thing about government, because you know the Illuminati always try in countries like Spain and France and Italy and UK, which are backwards in times of internet backbone, to encourage people to develop the net. You don't have to encourage anyone. And by encouraging, they mean paying hundreds of millions of dollars to the big companies. You don't have to do this. You only have to pass three laws. First, we should not give any law regarding the regulation of the internet. Everyone is free to do what they want. Second, no one is allowed to ask the permission of anyone if they only want to drill some holes and lay some cables. Everyone is free to use the posts of the state, the telegraph posts, for instance, or the electrical posts, to lay down the cables. And third, there are no taxes, you know. In order to encourage a field, you only have to cut down all the laws and all the taxes regulating it. If you do this, then a lot of people will start doing that. If you are no longer hindering people from doing their stuff, people will actually starting to do their stuff. It will be like a magic wand or a magic hand of the economy. But in order to have access to the magic hand, you have to let the magic hand act. You have to cut down the laws in the USA, which say we only allow 3 carriers and 10 mobile frequency per city. Why? You can have a telecom frequency from 0.5 megahertz to 0.5 megahertz, or from 0.25 kilohertz to 0.25 kilohertz. This has happened with radio. They are like radio frequencies. You can have an infinite number because the spectrum is very large. There is low band, high band, middle band, all the there are frequencies, you know, in visual range, from the infrared to ultraviolets. There are from microhertz to gigahertz. Of course, human technology is still limited, but still, there is no reason to limit the number of frequencies and to sell those frequencies for millions of dollars and to be a system of bribes which go to the coffers of the city and to the salaries of, because you know, I saw companies like Comcast and Time Warner paying millions of dollars to the for lobby for influence trafficking, which by the way in Romania it's a crime. It is a crime to bribe some politician, you know, to pay him money in order for him to pass a law which is favorable to you, because laws must reflect the general interest of the society, and the general interest of the society is determined by referendum and through elections, you see. Capitalism is a wasteful and crazy system in most parts of the world, and that is why it was replaced by communism. Also, in the Cold War, during the Cold War, there was communism both in Russia and USA, because as Yuri Andropov said, he only ruled Russia for 3 months before he was killed, but he said he was an old man, he was chief of KGB, and he said there are several ways, there are several instances of capitalism. First, we have the medieval age, and we have the landlords and the peasants. And by the way, also in America and UK, there is the term used landlord, which is used for people who own houses. And many peons or peasants move in those houses and they pay rent. They are like the peasants who work on the fields of their landlords, who were serf or slaves, you know. And you will say, oh, these people are free to move. Yes, in the Middle Ages, also the peasants were free to move from one landlord to another. They had the freedom to choose their master. Do you want to be the slave of that master, or you want to be the slave of the other master? But they did not have the freedom to not be a slave. So, this is quite complicated, you know. Slavery was never abolished. Now, in order to convince that guy to lay down a cable on a post, you have to either give him a woman to fuck, you know, nice girl to fuck, or you have to pay him good money, or you have to trick him into believing that you pay him good money while you keep most of the revenue for yourself. Or you have to go to Africa and bring some slaves to yourself, or you have to make financial systems and make people the slaves of their own desire. For instance, I told to my uncle, who was in the Illuminati, in the Freemasons, he was 36 rank, unfortunately he died, and he told me, no one is forcing you to go and make a loan from a bank. No one is forcing you to buy an iPad, an iPhone, or a new computer. You're free to choose. And in the ancient age, people were not free to choose. They were made slaves after wars. So they were free to choose, sort of speaking. The rulers were free to choose to go to war or not. And the common people would say, oh, let's go to war and conquer. And they went to war, and they lost the war, and they were made slaves, you know. And after they were made slaves, they were forced to work. No. So, in the modern age, we have a different system. First, there's an advert, there is marketing on TV, and companies pay a lot for marketing. Approximately half of the price you pay $1,000 for an iPad, but you pay only $100 for a Chinese tablet, which is twice as better. An iPad has only a dual core processor with 512 megabytes of RAM, or half gigabyte. You get a quad core tablet with a full gigabyte, an Android tablet, not as polished operating system, but you know, at a nano computer, at a tablet, what could you expect? You cannot make you know, serious things with a tablet. And some people prefer, yes, the iOS is a polished system. Steve Jobs worked all his life, and I greatly appreciate it. But in the end, it is the usage model. It does not matter if the icons are 3D or 2D, if there is glass or no glass, if there is flat design or sinusoidal design or I don't know, if the notebook has gray or black things, if the icons are, because I know, you see, there is the fashion in the Dragon world. There was a game, there is a game called Sword of the Stars. And there is a scenario called the Upstart of the Apes, and the humans are going up in the galaxy, and the galaxy is dominated by the dragons, and the humans are very efficient, are spreading around, but you can also play with the dragons, which have lots of colonies. But in order to simulate the fact that the dragon society is decadent, they have an emperor, and the emperor, like you know, like the king, like the queen of England, from time to time decides to change the fashion. So he says or she says, well, now the missiles are at fashion. Everyone must make destroyers and cruisers with missiles. In 2 years, when you have made your fit and you are ready to attack the humans, she said or he says, the emperor has decreed that the missiles are no longer fashionable. Now lasers are in fashion. Now you have to destroy all your ships and make new ships with lasers. In 2 years' time, the lasers are no longer fashionable. Now you have to build all your ships with guns. So, this is how the things were. There is the world of fashion. And with all the fashion, the fact that the dragons have a black and white vision, my father is also obsessed with fashion, and I drew something in grayscale and he couldn't say the difference. I realized that he has black and white vision. You have the option to choose, you know. There is said in the dragon that you have no choice, but you always have a choice. You may not like the choices that you have. They are not pretty choices from time to time, but still you have the right to choose. And this system is very wasteful because it is based on fashion. There was it was a fashion in the operating system world when the video cards were not as powerful as today. For 20 years, everyone had to imitate the real life. So if you had an application called Notebook on macOS, it must actually look like a notebook. If you have a window in Windows, it must actually look like a window with glass margins. If you have an object, it must be a 3D object. The icons must be like a file with the things coming out of them. And then it was decided in the great wisdom the dragons had decided. Now we have flat design. Now everything is flat. Now you no longer see in Windows if that is a label or a button, because it is flat, it is not 3D, and or any marking is forbidden. Now you have to guess, and we have color boxes, you see. And maybe in 20 years time they will decide that it is black and white, you know, with shades of gray, that there will be four colors, like the Apple notebooks: white, black, light gray, and dark gray. Yes, and with these four colors, all the colors of the spectrum will be removed. There will be flat design, and everything will be black and white. We see it macOS in some parts is fashion. So it might look nice. I have met a dragonic girl who always on her Yahoo Messenger account had black and white pictures, and then her account. So my dear friends, capitalism is really wasteful with resources. That is why communism was so successful. Not because people were smart, or they were very lazy and stupid in communism. And not so stupid because people used to learn a lot, there were not many distractions and or places to go. So people just, you know, spend their money on books and movies. That is the reason why literature and movie production was encouraged in Romania during communism. there was a great cultural movement and those things. And usual firm in the West, it has great cost which they pass down to the consumer. That is why you pay 20 times more for the same capability. It is not only the fact that the workers in the USA have $6 per hour income and the workers in Vietnam have 20 cents per hour income. It is also a difference of work, of working ethics. You say, you see, a man in Malaysia, I think it was the king of Malaysia, told me, you know, in our country, in Malaysia, people work 14 days per week. And I say, how is it possible? Because I know that 1 week has only 7 days. Maybe you are using the Mayan week, which has 19 working days out of 20. He said, no, we are working 12 to 16 hours each day. Why people in Europe and America work only 6 to 8 hours each day? And thus, we are producing in Malaysia, Singapore, Hong Kong, Singapore, Hong Kong, India, China, Japan, South Korea, even North Korea, Vietnam. Do you know that Vietnam and Bangladesh and Pakistan and Nigeria are among the top 10 countries in the world in which they have developed broadband mobile network, and they have one of the greatest broadband mobile speeds on the world. They also have one of the greatest number of people who have mobile phones in the world. Now there's a nice girl on TV. She has a funny hat with yellow, blue and red. Reminds me of the flag of Romania, but it is the flag of Colombia. You see, Colombia was first the land of the Mayans, then the land of the Aztecs. What about Guatemala? What about Bolivia, my friends? What about the oil? Yes, what about Paraguay? I am getting ahead of myself. Yeah. So, this is the matter with capitalism. It is very easy to build a firm in capitalism. Of course, you must convince a bank to grant you a loan. And you see, my uncle told me, you know, we are living in a communist world. And in a communist world, everyone will be forced to work. We are coming the new world age, where everyone will be forced to work. And do you know what country will be the playground of the Illuminati? Russia. Because I know the Senator McCain said, in a very naive statement, that Russia needs to conquer Ukraine because Ukraine is Russia is a country of Ukraine, but with Ukraine it is an empire. When in fact, by studying history, you will learn that Kiev was the first capital of Russia before it was burned down by the Mongols. So the Ukrainians are Russians. They are Vikings. They are a tribe of southern Vikings. They are a tribe of Rus. While in Russia, on the other hand, we have many other people. We have the Inuits, which are Mongols. We have the Turkmens, which are Turks. We have the Persians. We have the Chechens. Have you heard about the Empire of Krasnoyarsk in Siberia? Have you heard about the Republic of Satka, which was the empire, will be the empire of Krasnoyarsk, will be the empire of Satka, which occupies 2.3 million and soon 3 million square miles or square kilometers in Siberia. The whole it is the largest country on earth. If the Republic of Satka would separate from Russia, and Krasnoyarsk would also separate from Russia, those two countries would be the top two countries in the world as a land surface. Bigger than Canada, bigger than USA, bigger than Brazil, bigger than China, bigger than Australia. Bigger than whole damn European Union combined together. Not as much population, of course, but many raw resources, diamonds, oil, gas, gold, silver, copper, aluminum, or bauxite, what it is called. So, my good dear friends, let me tell you the truth. Capitalism is fucked in the ass. And it will fall down. Because, as Yuri Andropov said, first we had in the medieval age those people who were slaves. So the first merchants and capitalist guys that work in guilds. You have today in Astro Empires and other movies on the net guilds. Yes, like the ancient guilds of the tailors. There is included the guild of tailors, and there is a nice girl which I love there. And she also dresses very nice because she is a tailor, and the tailors know how to make clothes, and for themselves and for others. So it pays to have a job. If you have a job, you know how to do some things, and you can exchange the things that you do. And this is valid also in communism, capitalism, in any other social structure invented by man. There might be someone to lay down the cable, the internet cable. Of course, in the very near future, it will be a machine or a robot, but we are not there yet. So we must rely on the work of others or on our own work to do things. Potatoes are cheap or expensive, but if you can have free potatoes if you plant your own potatoes and you water them and you wait about 3 to 6 months. Yes. I gather potatoes and I planted potatoes. I know how it is done. So I have found my first job, a potato man. Potato plant, gather, maybe seller of potatoes. And so this is how the world works. Do not rely on others, rely on yourself. Know your rights. I have the right to be paid $1 million per day if I found someone who will pay me $1 million. If I don't find someone who pay $1 million, then I have the right to ask $1 million for my services, and other people have the right to pay me or not. If I take a loan from the bank, my uncle said me, well, if the bank gives you a loan, the bank takes money from the people, from the work of other people, basically, the people who have worked, and they deposited the money at the bank. Of course, there is a fractional reserve limit, and now in USA the fractional reserve limit is zero, in Romania 16%, which means that in Romania each bank can create as much money as people have worked. So they create money out of nothingness, and we have an economy like in EVE Online, where people are basically mining and selling the minerals or transforming them into ships, and then everyone is happy and the economy is growing and all the prices are growing, and you know, you can see the inflation, because a Velator, which is a rookie ship, used to cost under 1,000 credits, 967 credits, and the other frigates were about the same. Now a frigate costs about half million credits. If you want a destroyer, there will be 2 to 4 million credits. If you want a cruiser, 12 million credits. If you want a battle cruiser, 40 million credits. If you want a battleship, 200 million credits. Or ISK, which is also interstellar credits, but also means Icelandic Corona. If you want a dreadnought, 2.5 million credits. If you want a freighter, 1.5 million credits, or 3 billion credits. Billion. A dreadnought is 2.5 billion credits. If you want a Titan, well, the skill book is 5.5 billion credits. The materials are 120 billion credits. 50 billion credits are the installations required, because you must build a Stargate and an array to, and in the end about, you know, 200 billion credits. If you buy the credits, the ISK online, you can pay $10 for a billion, that will mean about $2,000. If you buy the ship online already made, it will be $9,000 for you truly. You see? So the work does matter. people in Romania will appreciate the people with money and power. But now they will start to appreciate people who work, because I have worked for free for them, and I told them, if you do not pay me, I will stop working for you. Even if you do pay me, I'll stop working for you, because my mandate is almost finished. So you know, you have to, even if you don't, even if you believe that people with money and power are the best, you must also appreciate the work, the free work of others, because if you do not appreciate the work, then you will not benefit from the free work of others. And then if you do not benefit, then you will have to learn yourself, and it is a great thing to learn yourself. The best experience you can give to other creatures is to give them the consciousness, experience of letting them work and learn on their own skin, you know? So, tschüss. Bye-bye.